The next option that we'll be looking into to test out your Kubernetes cluster is called Kubeadm. Kubeadm is actually a real-time setup. Using Kubeadm tool, we can set up multi-node Kubernetes cluster, and it is very popular, and you can have multiple VMs on your machine and configure the Kubernetes master and its node components. If you have limited resources but want to use Kubeadm, then you can use some cloud-based virtual machines, which is something that we'll be doing in this particular video. So I'm going to be using Civo instances, but before we get started with that, let's look a bit more into what are the requirements for running Kubeadm. So before we begin, this is the official website of the Kubernetes docs. It mentions that a compatible Linux host, for example, a distribution like Debian, Red Hat, you can even use like Ubuntu and stuff. So that would be required. 2 GB or more RAM per machine, 2 CPUs or more, and full network connectivity between all the machines in the cluster, public or private network is also fine. You also need unique host names, MAC addresses, and the product UUID for every node. You can check out this example for more details. Certain ports need to be open on your machine. And this is the important part, which is swap should be disabled. And the reason for this is something that we'll also discuss when we'll be doing the hands-on coding part. Cool. So these are a few prerequisites, like some basic checks that you need to verify. And you can do those via these commands. And you can also let your IP table see bridge traffic. And you can also check the required ports. So all the required ports that are, that we're going to be requiring. And you can also see the purpose of what these particular ports are going to be used for. For which service are they going to be used for? So that's pretty much about it. And we're going to be installing like Kubeadm, Kubelet, Kubectl. And I'll also show you how to install Containerd, because we do need to install a runtime. You can use like Docker, Containerd, CIRO. So in this particular session, we'll be using Containerd. And we'll be using the instances on Civo Cloud. And I'm going to show you how easy it is to set up your instances on Civo Cloud. So basically, we'll be having a control plane, and we'll be having like 2 nodes, for example. So in other terms, we can say a master node and 2 worker nodes, for example. Without further ado, let's get started. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to go to this particular URL on my account. Or you can just, if you're at the dashboard, you can click on like compute, instances. So I'm going to create 3 instances over here. Let's see. So I'll create my first instance, for example. So I'm going to give it a name like, let's say control plane. And I'm going to create 1 instance of this. Let's keep this as medium. And I'm going to select the base image as Ubuntu. Rest everything I'm going to keep by default. I'm going to click on create. And let's create 2 more. So basically, I'll create 1 more instance. And this one is going to be called, let's say, node 1. And it's going to be of, let's say, small size. And I can have the base image as Ubuntu. And I'm going to create this. Let's create 1 more. I'm going to create a 2nd one. So this one is going to be called, let's say, node 2. And again, you can have some small or whatever you like. Then I can have Ubuntu, and everything else I can keep by default. So you can see in my instances now, I believe we have 3 instances being created. These ones are getting started, but you can see how easy it was to, start a particular instance. For example, I click on this, and now I want to work with this. So you can see this address over here. I can just SSH into it. So I can say something like SSH root at the URL, whatever IP at, that we have over here for the host. And it's saying, do you want to connect? I'm going to be saying yes. And now it's going to ask for a password. So the password is something you can find from here. So you can click on the view SSH information. This is currently hidden for me. So I'll just copy this and then I'll just paste it over here. How simple was that? Now I'm in my particular instance on my local machine. I'm controlling it via SSH. Cool. So that was the first step. And what we need to do now is we're going to be installing some packages. So the particular command, you know, if you want to SSH into each node and create a containerd configuration file, we can do that via executing the particular command. So I'm just going to copy and share it over here. So now you can see this command is going to instruct the node to load the overlay and the brnet filter kernel modules. We also have to restart our nodes to load them. So, you know, instead of restarting, we can run the below commands to load the modules immediately. So sudo mode probe overlay and sudo mode probe for the second module as well. The next step is going to be to set the system configuration for the Kubernetes networking. So you can set your bridge and your IP and everything. Let me clear this. There we go. So now you can see it's basically now we have to apply these settings by executing the sysctl command on the system. So these are now applied, and the next step is the, you know, the important part, which is installing containerd. So I can just do apt-get update and install containerd like this. I'm going to zoom out a little bit so you can see, and I'll also show you the history of the particular file. It's taking some time. By that time, I can, it's already done. So this was basically the command in case you missed it. All right. The next step is that inside the slash etc folder, we're going to create a configuration file for containerd, and we're going to generate the default file for that. I'm just going to copy paste that. So first thing I'm going to do is I create a containerd file. There we go. Pretty simple stuff. And I'm going to generate the default configuration for that. So you can see our default configuration is set. And now I'm just going to restart my containerd to ensure that the new configuration file, you know, is being used. You're going to type that command for over here. Now, remember when we talked about in the previous video that we need to disable swap memory? Well, this is the reason that, you know, Kubernetes requires us to do that, because the scheduler in Kubernetes determines the best available node on which to deploy the pods that will be created. So if the memory swapping is, let's say, allowed to occur on your host system, then this will lead to some performance and stability issues within Kubernetes. So for this particular reason, when we'll be running Kubernetes, it's going to require us to disable the swap memory. In Linux, you can do it simply like that. Sudo swap off dash a. And now we're going to just install a few dependency packages. So in order to install some dependencies, we're going to be installing app transport HTTPS here. And then the next step is basically to download and add the GPG key. So I'm just going to download that from the Google Cloud packages.googlecloud. And let's add that. Cool, that is done. And now the next step for us to do is adding the Kubernetes to the repository list. So I'm just going to add that like that, doing a cat. And that looks good. So far, we are doing pretty good. The next thing is something we're going to do is update the package listings. So the command for that is sudo apt-get update. And then we're just going to install the Kubernetes package. Notice something that if you're using a dpkg lock message, if you get a dpkg lock message, then just wait for a few minutes before trying the command again. So I'm just going to run this. Hopefully we won't be facing any issues. So installing the Kubernetes package right now. So as you can see, it's installing kubelet, kubeadm, and kubectl. So it's saying setting up kubeadm. That looks good. If you want to see the command again, this was the command. Sudo apt-get install. I am installing kubelet, a specific version, kubeadm, and kubectl. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to turn off the automatic updates by putting this on hold. So I already ran that. So I'm going to put this on hold. So you can see now it's going to turn off the automatic updates. Now the next step is what we're going to do is we're going to be initializing our cluster. Now this particular step only needs to be done on the control plane node or the master node. So if you have multiple control plane nodes, then you can do the same thing on each and every one of these. So I'm going to start it by, I'm going to do an init over here, the kubeadm init command to initialize my particular cluster. So it says that it might take a minute or two, depending on the speed of the internet connection. I'm going to open another terminal over here. I believe we also have our other instances running, so like our worker nodes or, you know, other nodes. So yeah, as you can see, these are running. Now that looks good, and still it's in progress. By that time, we can also, I think it's already done. Yeah. So you can see there's a kubeadm join message, and this is an important one. So basically keep note of this thing, and I'm just going to copy this and you know, keep note of this thing because this is important. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to set the kube ctl access. For that, I'll also need to copy this so that I don't forget it. I think I, just one second, just gonna save my keys somewhere, and then we'll do kubectl, we'll add the kubectl access. So I'm gonna make a directory, and I'm gonna do copy, sudo cp for this. That looks good. And now I'm just gonna give it access. Perfect, that works. In order to test how that is working, you can check kubectl version. Ta-da! So our particular kubectl and the cluster is now working. So we are able to now access the cluster. We can also add, for example, we can also install Calico network add-on. So Calico provides a simple and high performance secure networking, and it's trusted by a lot of major cloud providers. So on the control plane, we can install the networking via doing kubectl apply. So we can apply, we can send in a file over here. And in case you want to see what all components it's basically installing, so you can do that via kubectl get pods, and I can say kube system. So you can see it has all these pods. All right, now the next thing we need to do is that in the worker node, we actually have to do this entire process again. So what we need to do is that we have to do this entire thing in our particular worker node. So let's go back to our worker node. I'm going to show it this for you for just one node, but you can do it for as many as you like. So I'm going to copy this. I'm going to SSH into it. SSH root at this. I'm going to say yes. Then I'm going to add my password. So my password is basically copy this, add the password, and now I believe I'm in. So you're just going to do the exact same thing for this as well. So I'm going to do the installing packages. And we can have to restart the nodes. Then we're going to have to set the system configurations. And we're going to have to apply these settings. And then we're going to install Containerd. So currently I'm just doing the same thing that I did previously. Because we're going to be running kubeadm on this as well, right? So in this particular node also, we need to have kubeadm. But we're not going to initialize the cluster over here. the previous command that we got, the join command, is something that we're going to be using over here in order to connect it with our control plane. I'm just going to restart Containerd after this. Turn off the swap memory. And install the dependencies. Download the GPG key. Add Kubernetes to the repository list. Update the package listings. And in the end, just install kubelet, kubeadm, and kubectl. Last but not least, we're going to have to also turn off the automatic updates. So you can see it's setting up kubeadm and turn off the automatic updates. Cool. So we already did the initialization of our cluster, so we don't have to do it over here. And the next thing that we need to do is we have to join using the command that we got previously, sudo join. All right, I see what the issue is. 1 second. Nice. So I copy pasted. So always look whenever you're copy pasting. Cool. So you can see that this node has joined the cluster. And now it says that if we run kubectl get nodes, so I can just say kubectl get nodes, we're going to be able to see this particular node over here. How cool is that? We have a master node and this particular node is this one. That was it about this particular installation, and I hope you were able to set up kubeadm, and now you can just, you know, set up more nodes, play around with them, learn more about like how the networking is working, and I hope you enjoyed this particular video. We'll see you in the next one.